Hey guys, what's up? Today, I'm going to show you how to do this really cool foam projection hologram effect in Adobe After Effects. Let's get to it. So, as you can see, I've already got my project set up, ready to go. So I put a few clips in here in the order that I want it to play out. So I just have a couple intro shots here. Then I cut to an overhead of me using my phone. Then these two longer shots here of me using my phone are gonna be the ones that we're going to use to add that kind of projection effect in the empty space around here in this clip. And maybe around this area here for the second clip. So we're basically going to show the contents of my phone screen projected in a hologram style in that empty space. So first what you're going to want to do is grab your screen recording and place it in your composition here. So this is quite big. So I'm going to just move it a little bit, hold shift, and then drag the corner to resize it while keeping the ratio there. Okay, so I'm happy with how that looks right now. All right, good. So this has been placed here over my first clip of me using my phone. So we're also gonna drag this to line up with my clip here. So this is gonna play just as that clip starts. Now I'm gonna cut the clip so that I can continue at a different point for the second shot of me holding my phone. So wherever the current time indicator is, if you hit Command-Shift-D on your keyboard if you're on Mac, or Control-Shift-D if you're on Windows, it'll split the clip in two. So I usually just delete the second half of that clip once I'm done with it. Now the first thing I want to do is I want to give this a little bit more of like a hologram-y, blurred out edges kind of effect. So we're going to make sure that clip is selected in the timeline here. Then we're going to go on up to the pen tool. And then we're going to draw out a rectangle, but if you notice, because of my screen recording, I have a bit of a red bar up here that kind of signals that I am in screen recording mode. So I don't really want that to show in this clip. So I like to start my mask a little bit lower down. So I'm gonna click my point right around here. And I also want it to be a little bit in from this left edge here so that there'll be a little bit of fade out on that side as well. So make sure it's down from the top and a little bit in from the left side. So I'll click there. Then if you hold shift, it should make it in line with the first point. So then I'm gonna click at roughly the same distance away from the opposite side. Then I'm gonna go all the way down to the bottom. So maybe around here, across to the opposite side. And then finally, you wanna close this shape up above. So now this has created a mask on that projection layer. So what it basically did was it cuts out anything that's outside of that rectangle we just created on this layer, but we're at a similar point that we currently were at. It's just a sharp edged rectangle. So I want to be able to fade out and kind of blur out those edges a bit. So if you go down below, you hit this little triangle to open up the options for this screen recording. Then you go to the mask section, open that up as well. And then you'll see mask feather. So you can just click on either one of these two since they are linked right now. And you can drag that number to make it bigger. So if you'll notice, we've gained a lot back here from this video layer, but it's faded it out. So it's created a nice soft hazy effect. Then next, what you're gonna wanna do is close the mask layer, and then under that same screen recording layer, if you go to transform, under opacity, drag that down just a little bit so you can start seeing your scene through it. So that's not quite enough for the look that I'm going for, so I'm gonna try to reduce that a little bit more. Okay, I think I'm happy with 65%. So now I'm gonna drag this time indicator back a little bit, hit spacebar to play that. And there you go. I'm happy with how that looks so far. Now, the only thing is, I think this clip starts a little bit too late. I wanted the scrolling to start a lot sooner. So I'm gonna go to the point here in which, just before the scrolling starts, and I'm gonna drag this clip, the beginning of this clip, to that point, and then just kind of realign it with the start of this clip. Now, because it is shorter, now we just have to extend the end there to where we want it to go. Let's play it back. Now you see this hologram floating screen effect. Now you can do the exact same thing with a second screen recording for the second clip that we have here, but I'm gonna skip right ahead to the next part of this. So although this does look kind of cool, I think what would look even cooler is if we had this hologram floating screen effect motion tracked to the phone. So as you can see, as I scrub through this, my phone is moving as I start scrolling and as I'm touching the phone. So I think it would be kind of cool if this hologram projection effect is also moving in sync with the motion of the phone. So what you're gonna wanna do is make sure that the original video layer is selected by clicking on it down here, bringing the time indicator to the beginning of that clip, then go up to animation, track motion. So now it added a track point to this video clip. So if you click on it, you can expand the window a little bit so it's easier to grab and maneuver. So you're gonna wanna bring this over and find a point of high contrast so that you can easily track it once you do run the tracker. So I've tried this before and I thought the Apple logo would be good, but because it's not really clear, it wasn't the best of spots. So I'm gonna try putting it on this finger right over here, since that finger doesn't really move much throughout this clip. So I'm gonna put this right there on the nail, and I'm gonna expand out this window just a bit so that it has an easier time tracking that object. Then under the tracker panel on this right hand side here, underneath analyze, you can click this play button so it'll play through the clip and analyze the footage. So as you can see, it's doing the best that it can to track my finger there, which is moving with the phone. If the object isn't of high enough contrast, it might have a much harder time tracking it. So you can kind of play around until you find a good spot on the object that you want to track. Once that is done, while the original video layer is still selected, you want to go up to layer, new, and null object. This has to be directly above your original video layer. I do like to trim it to the length of my actual clip that I have. After you've trimmed the null object, make sure you still have your original video layer selected, then back under the tracker on the right hand side, you go to edit target and change this to the null object. So in my case, it's called null 2, but yours might be called something else like null 1, null 3. So once you click on that, hit okay, and then you click apply. Make sure X and Y is checked off and hit okay. So now it basically attach that null object to that track point. So as I'm scrubbing through, you can see that right over there, the red box is following the track point. So the last step is to attach your screen recording projection effect to that null object so it tracks and moves with it. So we click on our screen recording layer, then go over to where this little swirly icon is, click and hold and drag it to the null object. Once you let go, that layer is now tracked to the null object, so it'll be moving along with that phone object. So now we're gonna go back and play it again. And there you have it. I hope you enjoyed this tutorial. It's pretty straightforward and pretty easy, but if you have any questions, please let me know by leaving me a comment down below. Also, if you like this video, make sure to smash that like button, and as always, don't forget to hit that subscribe button as well. If you hit that little bell notification icon that's right beside the subscribe button, you'll get notified every single time we drop new videos, just like this one. Stay tuned, there's a lot more cool stuff coming your way, but until next time, keep creating guys, peace out.